Over the last 18 months, the biotech sector has catapulted to the forefront of all of our minds as we've anxiously awaited for drugs and vaccines to pull us out of the pandemic. At Bessemer, we have two deeply intertwined roadmaps. First, our biotech roadmap, which refers to the business of making new drugs. And second being our pharma IT roadmap, which is focused on the technology companies that enable the biopharma industry to execute on developing, manufacturing, and selling these drugs. There are many subsectors within each of these roadmaps, and each are often billion-dollar plus opportunities. Today, we're focusing on how this nearly trillion-dollar industry is transforming rapidly in light of COVID-19. As the scientific and healthcare community keeps a close eye on Delta and Mu variants, the biopharma industry is also positioned to drive innovation across the globe, which inspired our new roadmap we're calling Drugs in a Virtual World. When we think about the pharma value chain, there are three areas we are often looking at: drug discovery, or finding new drug targets to pursue; clinical trials to test whether these drugs are safe and effective in humans; and sales and marketing to finally generate revenue. There are some significant challenges that have been highlighted during the pandemic, most notably in clinical trials, supply chain, manufacturing, and sales. While we think big companies can be built across the value chain, we want to spend some time discussing the clinical trials space in particular. Any one of the drugs that a biotech is developing is brought to market through a very strict, highly regulated, and time-intensive process. Our belief is that one of the greatest entrepreneurial opportunities today lives across the clinical trial value chain, given the urgent and unique window of opportunity the current pandemic presents. The last year has been a watershed moment for many industries due to COVID-19, and for pharma, there are three key reasons why now is the time to restructure the clinical trial paradigm. First, the preferences of clinical research participants are changing, driving the industry to build more virtual, patient-centric approaches. As hospitals were consumed by COVID-19 care and social distancing forced many of us to be home, 80% of clinical research participants said they were unwilling to visit a hospital to participate in a clinical trial. The industry had to mobilize to bring new technologies like telemedicine and at-home monitoring to complete their clinical trials with better results. In fact, 98% of trial participants were satisfied with telemedicine, and 72% of doctors said remote visits were similar or even better than in-person visits. Second, cost effectiveness and trial efficiency are necessary while COVID-19 puts additional financial pressure on drug developers, as the cost of bringing one new drug to market is estimated to be upwards of $2.6 billion. New starts of clinical trials declined 50%, and 60% of trial investigators reported a reduction in clinical trial activities as a result. At one point, 77% of ongoing trials were delayed, and 31% of trial sites feared closure. These delays can cost $600,000 to $8 million per day, and drug companies are looking for any way to make their operations more efficient. Lastly, regulatory tailwinds are pushing software-enabled clinical trials to the forefront. The Cures Act 2.0, the Digital Health Innovation Plan, and additional FDA guidance has paved the way for digital tools and other technology in clinical trials. There are several areas we see the most opportunity. First, decentralized clinical trials, often referred to as virtual trials, bring the clinical trial to the patient, either in their home or at their local doctor's office, and reduce the industry's dependence on costly, inconvenient, and homogeneous in-person patient interactions. Startups focusing on decentralizing trials can either bring trials directly to a patient's home, leverage community doctors and primary care physicians to expand the pool of potential patients and reduce travel time, or even simply providing software tools to enable as much at-home participation as possible. Secondly, patient recruitment startups are emerging with proprietary data and applications of AI and machine learning to cost-effectively find and enroll trial participants. Recruiting patients is the most expensive part of a clinical trial, accounting for upwards of 40% of all trial expenses. Traditional media channels are no longer meeting the needs of the biotech industry for recruitment, and several emerging companies are using bottoms-up approaches with proprietary patient data, for example, medical records, and machine learning to more effectively find and recruit patients into trials. Third, remote patient monitoring tools are now being used to more effectively collect, structure, and analyze trial participant data. Over the last two decades, the usage of digital products in clinical research has grown at a remarkable 34% compounded annual growth rate. However, only recently have these tools been capable of delivering regulatory-grade data that will enable remote trials to proliferate. Fourth, real-world data and evidence, which includes synthesized data from EMRs, claims data, and other proprietary datasets, allows pharma to understand the safety and efficacy of drugs in the real world outside of a clinical trial setting. We're seeing increasing interest in using this real-world data within clinical trials to both recruit patients, but also simulate the control arm, or the placebo group of a clinical study. As you can imagine, using a virtual control arm effectively eliminates the placebo group, reducing patient recruitment costs, speeding up trial timelines, and improving patients' willingness to join a trial if they know they're not going to get a placebo. Finally, virtualization isn't just hitting the trial itself. We're also seeing an emerging category of digital leaders focused on optimizing supply chains and manufacturing workflows to build the digital infrastructure to ensure that drugs and supplies are delivered and manufactured on time to meet patients where they are. Across each of these areas, we're looking at companies across the entire landscape. In short, there has never been a better time to be building digital health solutions for clinical trials. We're in a leapfrog moment for digital clinical trials similar to the scientific revolution that gene editing and immunotherapy created for biotech. Cloud computing has only just enabled these technologies that will change the trial landscape, and the current pandemic has created an urgency to transform how clinical research is done.